People in Power. Inspiring artists, empowering stories, your favorite films and stars up close and very personal. With your host, Ghada Aboud.
Hello and welcome to a new episode of People in Power. This is your host, Ghada Aboud. Please call me G. And director, Mr. Abdullah Munshi. Alright, everyone, how are you feeling? How's everything going on your side? How's your lunch break going? How are you driving, everyone? Are you driving safely? Are you using these seat belts? Like, even if you are sitting at the back seat, you know how powerful it is to always keep your safety and those of your loved ones. This is power. And let me ask you, how did you sleep? How do you feel? And how is your well-being going? I want to tell you and assure you, one step closer from everything that you want. And all you have to do is to trust the process, and everything gonna happen your way. And every dream you want is approaching you and running towards you as you're running towards it too. But run safely, run with a seat belt on. All right, so today we have a very special episode. Today we'll be speaking about the voice of Saudi Arabia in literature. She's a very, very, very successful, very talented writer, the author, the winner of Najib Mahfouz Prize in Literature, the Saudi writer Omaima Alkhamis, after this song.
Tastes like strawberries on a summer evening.
Number one means you're always on top. Your number one radio.
You're listening to SRFM.
I'm alive.
The radio station that plays you nothing but the best music. Music.
Right, everyone, and we are back with People in Power. This is your host, Ghada Aboud. Please call me G and director, Mr. Abdullah Munshi. And today we're talking about the Saudi author, Omaima Alkhamis. And let me assure you, she is the best writer ever. Like, you really, really love her work. And if you had read anything for her, please share your thoughts on her books and call me on 012-6484-691 or 012-6474-100. And you might ask me, why are you speaking today about Omaima Alkhamis? Well, because Omaima Alkhamis, what's very, very special about her is that she documents through a very brilliant talent of imagination and of fiction, our history and our heritage, right? She would start talking about how we developed and how our lifestyle evolved and developed from the 60s until now on, because she brings examples that is so similar to you and to your friends and to the people that you know. And because literature is, above all, is the best escape. It's not an escape as in it's not an escape in that meaning that you have to forget about your reality, but it's a way that you see your reality from a different point of view and from an inspiring point of view, right? And this is what Omaima Alkhamis does. She carries our heritage, she carries our the terminologies and our food and our stories and our hopes and our insecurities and everything. And she puts it in a very delicious, full meal that fills your eyes, your soul, your heart. This is Omaima Alkhamis. She is the voice of our identity, and she is one of the best writers ever. She won Najib Mahfouz Prize for Literature, and not only that, there's actually a ballet for children that was based on one of her books, and that was performed actually at the opening of the book fair of Vienna. How proud are you? How proud are you? And how can Omaima Alkhamis make us all proud? Omaima Alkhamis, everyone, and more to know about her, but after this song. Alright, and we are back with People in Power. This is your host, Ghada Aboud. Please call me G. And director, Mr. Abdullah Munshi. Right. Everyone in your cars, how are you feeling? People listening to me in Riyadh, Sharqiya, Jeddah, Jazan, everywhere in the around Saudi Arabia. How are you feeling? Did you figure out what you're going to have for lunch? You don't have to think a lot about it. Eat whatever you want to treat yourself to a good meal, because guess what? You deserve it. And enjoying these things in life, like the food, the good sleep, the landscape, everything is a treat and is power. And speaking of power, today we speak about the great author, Omaima Alkhamis. She's a Nobel, inshallah, she will be the Nobel Prize winner. She won a prize of Najib Mahfouz for Literature, who is, of course, a Nobel Prize winner. And let's go back to the upbringing and the environment which Omaima Alkhamis grew up in. And you might ask me again, why are we speaking about Omaima Alkhamis' upbringing? I'll tell you, your kids and your children are the product of the environment that you provide to them. And if you grew up in an environment that was not really complementing your ambitions or your dreams, be the first one who provides that and the chain, right? And let's go to Omaima Alkhamis. Omaima Alkhamis was born to be the daughter of a very famous historian, Saudi historian, Abdullah bin Muhammad Khamis. And her mother was Siham al-Sirhi. And her mom was actually the first Saudi woman to write and publish columns in a Saudi newspaper. And that newspaper was called Al Jazeera, still called Al Jazeera. It's a famous newspaper. Her father, as I said, is a famous historian. And when Omaima Alkhamis gave a speech when she won the Najib Mahfouz Prize, she said, "I would always remember the time when the evenings of every night when my father used to read and my mom used to revise over what my father was reading." Or my mom used to read and my father used to revise. They were together, they were life partners, both Siham al-Sirhi and Abdullah bin Muhammad Khamis. They were both interested in history, interested in literature. And there was the upbringing of Omaima Alkhamis. And she said that the books and all kind of books that was there all over the house, it was another companion and it was another member of the family. So this had contributed a lot into the upbringing of Omaima Alkhamis. She was from her very young age grew up listening to her father and mother talking and discussing a lot of books, stories, things about our history, information and valuable information about our history and heritage. And that would very much reflect on her work later on. Would she go for a career and started big from the beginning, or would she rather at first lead a different type of career until she feels that she is comfortable with publishing a book. Let's know more about that, but after this song.
Working 9 to 5, guess you can't do that, but when I try.
All right, everyone, and we are back with People in Power. This is your host, Ghada Aboud. Please call me G, and director, Mr. Abdullah Munshi. And today we're speaking about our great writer, Omaima Alkhamis. She's an author. She's an amazing, amazing author. And before the break, we were talking about her upbringing and her family. And we were speaking how she was born in Riyadh. She grew up within a very, very inspiring environment with her parents who were interested in literature. And she graduated she holds a BA in English literature from King Saud University. So another thing, so she was... She grew up among her family, like reading the history and everything. And now she was exposed to another kind of literature, which is the work of maybe Shakespeare, Oscar Wilde, and many, many more. And that, of course, the more you open you give yourself more a chance to be more exposed to whatever that is happening around you. Within your domain, the more you develop yourself and develop your skills. After that, Omaima Alkhamis had an English diploma from Washington University, and she went back to Saudi and she started a career in education. She started off as a teacher, and later on she was promoted to be the manager of educational relations and media at the Ministry of Education. But what was happening, like, when she was pursuing, or she was working as a teacher or at the Ministry of Education, Omaima Alkhamis started publishing columns, right? And then from these columns she started going into taking another further step. And she published in 1993 her first short story collections under the title of Adla Ahin Astawa in 1993. All right. She took one step, right? And after that, the many other steps into the world of literature followed with Omaima Alkhamis, of course, to our favor and to our luck, because her talent is really, really brilliant. So after that, she published Majlis al-Rijal al-Kabir, short story collections, 1994, where Aina Yadhhab al-Daw, Where Does the Light Go, 1996. And into in the middle of that, there were many, many children books, right? So as she was working as in education, she was also taking very, very important steps into the writing career, starting from her short stories collection and on to her novels. And to our luck, that in 2006, she published Al-Bahariyat. I cannot even know where to start and how to end, so that I can just give you how does this book is... It's just brilliant. Like, who do you like? Who do you read for? I mean, who like what? Are you like a Paulo Coelho kind of fan? Because Omaima Alkhamis is much, much better. Are you a Dan Brown fan? Because Omaima Alkhamis is much, much better. She gives you everything. She has like a huge collection, and it's like a buffet. Like, whatever you want, whatever you dream of imagination, Omaima Alkhamis gives it to you, right? Al-Bahariyat, everyone, we'll speak more about it, 2006, to our luck. But after this song...
So get in the car, you can ride it wherever you want.
SRFM, the heart of KSA.
All right, and we are back with People in Power. This is your host, Ghada Aboud. Please call me G and director, Mr. Abdullah Munshi. And today we're speaking about the amazing Saudi author, Omaima Alkhamis. All right, and we stopped at the year 2006 when Omaima Alkhamis published her novel, Al-Bahariyat. And what does Al-Bahariyat mean? I believe Al-Bahariyat means the, in English translation, the creatures that came from, or the people, the kind of people who come from the seashores, right? The people who come from the coast. But this is not the story of people who come from the coast. This is the story of the life that started in Riyadh. It didn't start, but how the... Of course it didn't start. It started from 1727 and maybe much before that. So it speaks about how life evolved, how our lifestyle evolved from in Riyadh, and how we see, like, she gives you a panorama that started from the 60s in Riyadh, all right, where the story begins, and on to our recent days. This is Omaima Alkhamis, and I want to tell you, do you like that kind of books that tells you like 12 type of characters? How to understand the people, how to understand your managers. 12 steps to convince, I don't know what, 13 signs of your body language. I'm telling you guys, you're really, really, really missing out, and you're not gonna get real information from these kind of books. Because what Omaima Alkhamis does, and she does really, really brilliantly, is that she gives you an amazing, amazing diversity of character. And they are all from your own environment. And she gives you a huge, amazing, in-depth analysis to each and every character. And when you read her characters, you tend to understand the people around you. And you see, and everything becomes clear. And you find, you sort of find a point of connection with the people around you. Because Omaima Alkhamis is a very good, you know, like, she's an author, but she is also a surgeon. Like, she's very good with, like, cutting, like, these characters into, like, the depth and the depth of them. So really, really, I don't know, I don't want to, if you like these books, like, The 7 Habits of I Don't Know What, but buy it. But I want to tell you, like, Omaima Alkhamis does it better, and she gives you more and more of insight into people. And what's very good about her literature, that she makes these people who are different from you closer. Instead of that type of books who makes you feel that you are different and people, like, and life is a war. It's not. But you just have to find what's in common. And Al-Bahariyat is one of the best books that's ever written, in my opinion. You can read it and tell me. But if I compare it, in all honesty, to 100 Years of Solitude by Gabriel Garcia Marquez, I'd definitely choose Al-Bahariyat any day, every day. Right? And what's very, very distinctive about Omaima Alkhamis, that she makes it obvious that there is nothing as so-called women literature and men literature. There is talent, because we should speak talent and we should not speak gender. Women, when they write, they don't write any differently than how men write, you know. Let's just speak, because she has the same insight. And who does she speak about? She speaks about your family, my family, our families. She speaks about Al-Malaz. She speaks about our cars. She speaks about the palm trees around us. She speaks about traditions. She speaks about our food. She speaks about our music. She speaks about our sense of humor. How our sense of humor in Saudi Arabia had evolved or changed from the 60s and until our recent day. She also speaks about how people who for certain or different type of circumstances might have come from outside Saudi Arabia and how they try to find a place within our Saudi society, how they survived or how they wanted to feel that they belong into to our Saudi society, how they continued and how they fought. They didn't fight, but it's more of a how they coped with it, or they found a place with it within our society, our traditions, our circles. It's a very, very good analysis of how we see ourselves and how the people from abroad see us. This is Omaima Alkhamis and that's Al Bahriyat. But in 2009, we'll speak about a ballet at Vienna Book Fair by Omaima Alkhamis. How amazing is that? After this song.
Talking to myself, thinking I need someone else, but I'm falling for you every.
Alright everyone, and we are back with People in Power. This is your host Ghada Aboud, please call me G, and director Mr. Abdullah Munshi. Right, and today we're our character in power is actually the Saudi author Omaima Alkhamis, winner of Najib Mahfouz Prize for Literature, and on that she speaks through her themes about the evolvement of the society in Riyadh, and it's very, very, I believe, important, and not only important, it's very inspiring, as Riyadh has become the city of the future, the city of dreams, where everyone is like wanting to be a part of that a great development and great journey that Riyadh is leading in business and in entertainment and cinema and so many fields, that we understand how this city took form and changed its colors into the dream and the iconic Riyadh that we see today. And that's what happens, and that's what we experience through Omaima Alkhamis books. And on to 2009, after she published Al Bahriyat 2006, that Omaima Alkhamis published Farashat al-Sahra, or The Desert Butterfly, and this children book, it's a children book, huh? And it was translated into like different languages, into Japanese, Korean, German, and even more. It was adapted into a ballet for children, huh? At the opening, and performed at the opening of Vienna Book Fair in 2012. How amazing is that? How amazing is that? Imagine that you are in Vienna and the families are there, and the name of a Saudi author at the book fair, right? Keeping us proud, making us proud, having a ballet adapted into a performance from her own work. And I mean, it's just brilliant. It's just amazing. And on before that, while, I mean, people who are successful, they're very much focused on their sorry, excuse me. People who are successful, they're not result oriented, right? They're more focused on their journey. They're more focused on their process. They're much focused on their own development. We see that Omaima Alkhamis didn't stop. And I want to give you some information. She is a Gemini, and we all know how Gemini people are very successful, and they keep their balance. And I mean, she's just amazing. In 2008, she published Al-Warifa. And if you are into auras and reading auras, I'm telling you, this book is so inspiring for you. I mean, she starts like by reading this character who is a doctor. It's just amazing how every time she meets a character at the door of her hospital, or through her colleagues, or even when she went to Boston for her master's, that she analyzes the auras of people. She sees auras like behind every person, a color, an animal or a plant. And through that journey of reading Auras, that we see this character and we see the humor of people and the families in Riyadh. We see her sisters, we see people taking different journeys in life. And Al-Warifa is really another one great and amazing book written by Omaima Alkhamis. And on does Omaima Alkhamis live on until she was on a very special meeting with a very special writer. He's really, really not on even a regional level that he is brilliant, but on international level he is just the best writer ever lived, really, like much better than Marquez, Saramago, whoever that you guys think they are better. She was on a very she was to meet a very important writer, but after this song.
You're like a sunshine, only giving good vibes anytime that you roll.
Alright, and we are back with People in Power. This is your host, Ghada Aboud. Please call me G and director, Mr. Abdullah Munshi. Today we are very happy to speak about the amazing Saudi author, Omaima Alkhamis. In 2018, Omaima Alkhamis won the Najib Mahfouz Prize for Literature presented by the American University in Cairo. That's one of the most niche prizes in literature. Najib Mahfouz, what Omaima Alkhamis is doing, it's not very far from what Najib was doing, which is documenting actually the life and the identity of each own country. We have to understand our history that we know so that we can go ahead with our future. Omaima Alkhamis won the prize of Najib Mahfouz, and this means that her novels were to be translated even into many different languages, to our luck and to everybody's luck. And Omaima Alkhamis' latest work was publishing the novel Al Ghazal. Of course, you can find her books in every bookstores and online. I really, really recommend that you read Omaima Alkhamis. She documents our Saudi heritage and identity. She's very good and she is very brilliant in her craft. Another example that keeps us all and make us all proud. And for many, many more examples to come. I thank you very much for my time with you today. This was Ghada Aboud for People in Power. Please call me G. And director, Mr. Abdullah Munshi, we thank him very, very much. I'll see you next time.